begin tonight with reports of a Vallejo police officer is dead. Officers are now going home to home and a massive manhunt for a cop killer accused, suspected of also robbing a bank and leading police on a chase.
Yeah, that shooting in Vallejo has our full focus tonight, and we're standing by for a news conference at Vallejo City Hall, expected to start any minute. While we're waiting for that, though, let's get right to KCRA3's Janet O. She's on the streets in this neighborhood where the search is going on. Still no suspect, Janet.
Yeah, that's right, Golston, and the search has been going on for more than 4 hours now. Janus Street here is blocked off, and this is where the shooting went down. You can see CHP patrol officers out here guarding this entrance, but multiple agencies are out here, in fact, assisting with the search for this suspect who is accused of shooting an officer. Now, just before 2 this afternoon, Vallejo police got a call about a bank robbery. Officers say the suspect fled in his SUV, ended up in this neighborhood where he ran on foot. An officer chased that suspect and was shot in the 100 block of Janus Street. That's where the suspect's SUV is still parked at this time. We talked to one neighbor who heard the gunshots.
Five, six. Pow, 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 pow. It don't make no sense, because I know if I would did, I'd be gone.
So you don't think he's here?
No.
Now, officers dressed in SWAT gear have been going door to door. They do not believe the suspect has left this Vallejo neighborhood. And by all accounts, you can tell that just by looking at the sheer number of resources out here on this street alone, you may not be able to tell, but there are officers from American Canyon, Fairfield, and Vacaville all around this area. We also saw firefighters from Vallejo and paramedics standing by just in case. You may also be able to hear at this time the helicopter flying above us, trying to get a bird eye view of the suspect and his whereabouts. So a lot of people out here searching for the suspect. Still no sign of him at this point. Golston, Kelly.
Janet, I want to ask you, we've seen some reports that there's possibly a second suspect. Is there any chance that two people have been working together on this? Are they looking for one particular person?
Yeah, and Kelly, at this point, we know that they are searching for one armed suspect. As for that second suspect, we have not confirmed that information, but a Vallejo newspaper is reporting that there were two suspects that were there when they robbed the bank wearing Halloween masks. But at this point, we have not confirmed that information for ourselves.
Okay, and Janet, we're going to keep with you just for a second here, because there's so much going on there behind you. And again, where you are, that is where the officer was shot. That's where this whole thing started, right?
Yeah, that's right, Golston. Janus Street, again, you're looking at the street that all this happened, unfolded this afternoon. It's blocked off, and they got several neighborhoods, blocks right here, blocked off in this whole area. But this is the main focus right here on Janus Street.
Yeah, and as you talk about that, Janet, we actually have another picture up. We can just see police officers canvassing the neighborhood right now. And you talked about seeing some SWAT or officers dressed up in SWAT gear. And have you continued to see that?
Yeah, you may not be able to see right now because it's dark, but there is a SWAT team. It's a regional SWAT team that is going door to door doing that search. They are armed. They are dressed just in case that the suspect fires back. And as I mentioned, this is happening on Janus Street. There is a specific location, specific address that we heard reports that they are focusing and honing in on, but we don't have confirmation if that's where the suspect is. They have been looking at that particular house since this afternoon, but still no word on the suspect, and they are still searching, so he may not be there. Now, some neighbors did tell us that they saw the suspect trying to enter into one of the homes, and we did talk to that neighbor who said that his mother had a close encounter with the suspect, but she was not injured in any of this incident that went down this afternoon.
Jana, we're looking at some aerial views. Describe kind of where you are in Vallejo. It looks very residential. Are there any businesses nearby, or is this like right dab in the middle of a bunch of homes?
No, Kelly, this is strictly just a neighborhood. There are no businesses nearby, so that's not being affected. And it's also not by a busy intersection or freeway, so traffic is not being affected at this point. It's basically, you know, you just see a lot of homes out here. And as I mentioned before, at 5 o'clock, none of the neighbors have been asked to evacuate the area. And at this point, if anyone does live in one of the homes that is blocked off, like here on Janus Street, police will not let them in if it's too close to where they are searching. But that has not happened yet. People have, for the most part, went back into their homes. There was just a big group standing outside and watching and curious to see what happened. None of them had seen the suspect themselves, but they were just waiting waiting to see if officers would arrest this man, but that hasn't happened yet. And the crowd that was standing out here is now gone, and they're back inside their house. So no evacuations, Kelly.
I know we continue to watch some of this video as you explain the scene to us. And I know we have some other pictures of police going through and actually knocking down some fences, trying to get to where they think the murder suspect is, the suspected murder suspect. And I'm just curious, were neighbors out there in the area shaken by it? We heard a couple of people that you talked to, but obviously this isn't something that occurs every day anywhere.
You know, in Vallejo, the neighbors here in this neighborhood say that this is not something that is new to them. You know, they've had shootings, they've heard it, they've seen suspect chases before, so they are not shaken by it. They're just hoping that this man is caught and that this whole thing is resolved. And so, you know, they're kind of just, they were patiently waiting by to see what happens. But as I mentioned, they are back inside their home. So, you know, they're calling it a night. They were standing out here in the cold for a long enough, you know, several hours. And so, you know, they're back. I think they're just tuning in, watching to see what happens on the media outlets for the most part.
Yeah, and again, Janet, as we continue to look at these pictures, just to remind people if they're just joining us, around 1:30 today, there was a robbery at a Bank of America, and then the robber, or possibly robbers, fled. Police chased them to this neighborhood where Janet is right now on Janice Street. And that is where a police officer was shot. We are hearing reports now from our partner KTVU that officer has died. We have not gotten any official response yet from the police department. We're waiting to hear from the police department and the city of Vallejo. As you look at these pictures here, this is the aftermath, and the search for a suspect, possibly two suspects, continues tonight.
KCRA3's Damani Lewis is live for us at Vallejo City Hall, where we're standing by for a news conference. Damani, as you wait, what are you hearing and what's the mood like there?
Well, the atmosphere is very quiet. We're still waiting for Vallejo Police Chief Robert Nicolini. He will be holding a news conference here, hopefully within the next couple of minutes, to address the robbery of the bank, as well as that officer being shot. But for right now, we're just standing by, waiting for this news conference to start. And of course, when it does, we will bring it to you live right here on KCRA3. For now, we're live in Vallejo. Damani Lewis, KCRA3 reports.
Yeah, I guess, Damani, at this point, you're not getting a lot out of those folks right now, or have they said anything to you about this incident?
You know, right now there aren't any police officials here on scene. I'm assuming that all of them will walk in together to make the announcement as to what exactly happened, hopefully outline what happened in this bank robbery shooting. But right now, a lot of people from the community, several people. I spoke with one man who's a taxi cab driver who said he's here just to find out more about the street closures and where police are going to be for the rest of the night. That is why he's here. And just a number of people that are here just wanting to look for some answers into all of what's happened today. Galston.
Yeah, obviously, because there's at least one, possibly two suspects out there on the streets of Vallejo, so it's understandable why people there would be concerned. We're also hearing from our news partner, KTVU, there in the Bay Area, that the robber or robbers actually wore Halloween masks during the commission of that robbery at the Bank of America that was on, let's see, Springs Road in Vallejo. Again, that was at 1:30 this afternoon. The robbers got away. The chase happened, and the chase wound up in this residential area you see here live. The police tape is up. That's because beyond that tape is where a police officer was shot. We are hearing from other news outlets, including our news partner KTVU, that officer has died as a result of a shootout with one of the robbers.
As we wait for that news conference, we're going to continue to stay on top of this, follow all of our reporters, and bring you any details as we take a live look at Janice Street out there in Vallejo, where a police officer has been shot and unconfirmed reports that the police officer has died. We have some other news to cover, but we'll, of course, stay on top of this for you in the meantime.